Kim Kesty here in the Spellbinders Creative Classroom, excited to create with you with your Birthday Basics Die Bundle. Now, those of you who purchased the bundle already have an amazing assortment of product to make so many cards, but I'm going to walk you through 5 different cards today, and they're all going to be quick, they're going to be easy, and because it is a die bundle, there's no stamping involved, there's no fancy techniques, just fun things to do with dies. So let's check out our bundle, a few pieces of our bundle. We don't have everything here, but I'm going to bring in pieces as we go. But our very first project is going to be this cute little birthday balloon card. Sweet, simple, just perfect for any birthday for anybody in your life. So I'm going to go ahead and move a little bit of this cardstock. Here's all your cardstock that came with your kit. I'm going to grab actually the black licorice is what we call this guy. It's going to be our card base. We'll quickly cut that in half. And you guys, as you're creating along with me, just know that you can pause the video at any time and, you know, go back and check your measurements, do your cutting, you know, whatever you need to do. So don't stress about that. You can watch this video as many times as you want. Now, I just cut that whipped cream in half, so it's 5.5 inches tall. Now, you also got some really cute pattern prints in your bundle, so you've got all kinds of fun prints here. And if you don't care for the print that I picked for my card, definitely pick your own, mix and match. So I'm going to trim this 4.25 wide. That's going to just match the very front of my card. So just use your basic adhesive, really everything that you need to create these cards, except for just a couple small little things, are all included in your kit. So you're just going to need your basic tools, your basic adhesive. Here's my little cheat sheet for creating my first mat. I'm going to leave as much as I can here of the paper for a new card base. We won't be using it today, but you definitely want to keep that in mind for creating another card later on. So this is just over 3.5 inches wide, and I'm going to go just under 5 inches tall. So now we've got our first little mat that's going to go on there. And now we want a piece of white. So really all you're doing is just building your basic mats to go on here. Oops, I made that a little bit skinnier. Some of you may have square dies or rectangle dies or other ways to do your card mat. So definitely use your best approach that you normally do. So we're basically looking for just a little orange outline here, because this piece right here is going to be popped up. Of course, if you don't want to pop it up, you don't have to, but I kind of try to share my tips and tricks as we go along here. And now you want to grab your birthday balloons, which is actually called the Uplift die set. And you can see that mine's been well loved. So you're going to use your third balloon down and just cut 3 different balloons. I've used the yellow from your kit, the pink from your kit, and then I just grabbed a piece of blue that was just a little scrap I had. Just grab any blue that catches your eye. And now before I get them all placed, I'm going to grab our cute little sticker pack. So here's your Colorful Life sticker pack. And this has a lot of fun embellishments. We'll be using a ton of these in our cards today. But I'm going to go ahead and open it because we for sure want to use the yay. Just going to kind of pop that there. And then I like to use some of these little extra accents as kind of like little glows on my balloon. There's going to be some left over here too, but maybe grab the yellow one and the pink one. And then those will be kind of shiny spots on our balloon. I'm going to kind of pop the blue. And don't worry about having the balloon kind of pop, you know, past your edges of your mat. That just gives your card a little extra oomph. Now, before I add these stickers on, I'm going to grab your twine that you have in your kit. So this is our fun blue twine, and we want to make some little strings for our balloons. And then as we go along, you can use foam dots, or you can do like I'm going to do. I'm going to bring a little bit of wet glue. So again, I do kind of want to let those set up for a minute because I'm going to come back later and tie these in a knot, but we'll just let those dry. We'll add our stickers, and then maybe we'll start on our second card while that dries. So super cute, right? Super easy. You're going to have so much fun with this balloon die. You're going to be cutting balloons everywhere for all kinds of cards. This card would be also super fun to do multiples of. Like you could knock 6 of these out in no time at all and you would be on your way. So like I said, I'm going to let these strings dry. I'm going to come back and tie them in a little knot, but we'll just set them aside for now. Don't let me forget to come back and tie those. All right. So card number 2, let me give you a little sneak peek of it. This one's a fun one. And this one's a little bit hard to tell on the picture, but look, it's got this fun little kind of opening. So you've got the card that opens, but it doesn't go all the way across. So this is a little bit different measurement. So we're going to start with our standard card base, and then we're just going to trim a little bit away from that. So super fun, right? So your card base is normally 8.5 by 5.5. This strip right here is going to be perfect for die cutting your border in a little bit. So first I'll just fold this in half. And now I know that I want the front of it cut away a little bit extra. Slide it in here and I'm going to cut away about 1 inch. Okay, so now we have this strip that we cut. Remember, we just cut our first card base, so we have this extra strip right here. So go ahead and just cut that to 5.5 inches tall. It won't matter if it's extra wide, of course. And then we're just going to adhere that to this inside front flap. You want the stripe to go all the way to the edge. For my card, I went ahead and grabbed this little green flower for the front. Of course, you can cut, you know, any pattern that you want, of course. So again, this one's going to be the 5.5 inches tall. And then the front is going to be 3.75. I don't mind if it hangs over a little bit, but I want to leave room for my washi tape. So I'm actually going to do 3.25 inches wide. So now you've got a fun little pack of washi tape in your kit, and I chose the sparkly because I thought the green was really fun. And I'm just going to add a little sparkly edge right where that card front meets. This is called the Circle Around die set. I use this die set all the time. You can tell my envelope's getting a little loved, used. So I went ahead and cut the second size circle out of just kind of a piece of aqua color cardstock. And then I've got this other kind of coordinating blue to cut my little smile out of. You want to be a little bit careful with your foam square placement so you don't have a foam square, you know, hanging over here, or you will glue your card shut. Now we'll grab our Always Smile little die out of here. Okay. So when you kind of release the paper from your die, try to save your little dot for your eye. I know sometimes that one's kind of an easy one to have it pop out and lose. So I thought it would be fun to cut a little tag. So I'm going to bring in our watermelon paper. I'm just going to cut a small little, do a little bit more than 2 inch. I'll do 2.25 inch. Just cutting a little strip out of here, then I'll actually be able to create a couple tags. And the tag for this card is just hand cut. So you see when I cut my first edge, I have my first angle. Flip your paper over backwards and you're going to get the same exact matching angle over here. So use a little adhesive to add your smile to your tag. Kind of go at the bottom. If it hangs over at the edges, that's just fine. Okay, now we're just going to kind of layer up our tag. I'm going to put this pink tag at kind of an angle here. And then I'm going to go back to our sticker pack because this also has a fun tag called Life is Sweet. And I thought that was just fun to kind of layer up. And then I'm going to grab one of our fun color buttons. And then I'm just going to add a little button here just to kind of embellish the top of this tag. And actually, I think I'm going to grab one more little flower off of this. I'm actually going to take this watermelon off because I want it for a different card. I know, isn't that cuckoo? I'm going to take this watermelon off and I'm going to add this fun little lime instead. So I just layered it with that extra little flower. But I love the green in here too because it ties it all together. So how fun, right? Sweet, simple, die-cut circle, hand-cut tag, your little smile, your little embellishments. You are good to go, and it's just kind of a fun card. A little bit different opening there. All right, still letting my balloon strings dry, so I'm gonna let those just be for a minute while I bring in our next card. This one also has a white card base, so now you know why we gave you those extra pieces of white in your kit. So I'm gonna go ahead and trim that down. And again, it's just cutting your whipped cream right in half. Okay, so you can see that this one also has the panel of patterned paper underneath. So again, pick whatever pattern you want. I'm going with the blue stripe, and I do want the blue stripe to be horizontal on my card, so I'll go ahead and cut this at 4 inches and at 5.25. I'm gonna leave a little white showing around the edge. Now what I've done next is I've grabbed the Border Basics die set, and then I've just pre-cut this scalloped border right here. You have 4 borders to choose from, and of course you can choose anything you want, but I just did a kind of a basic white scallop out of that guy. And you only need to cut one because you can just go ahead and cut this in half. Then we're going to do kind of a, it's almost going to be like making our own little die cut here in the middle. So I'm going to grab a little panel of our whites. I want a small little square. So I'm going to go about 2.75 wide. Then I'm going to do about 3.5 inches tall. So I just want this little square. I'm going to kind of build it up with my 2 borders right here. One on the top and one on the bottom. I'll be trimming the extra away. I thought it was kind of a fun way to use your border in a little bit different way. And I'll just trim that extra border away just on the edges, of course. I'm going to grab the black. I'm going to do a little black panel on top. This was the black wood left over from that first card base. I'm gonna do 2.5 inches wide. We'll double check, see if it fits on here. Closer to 3.5 inches tall. So see how we've created this little, almost like a frame for this black cardstock. So that's the piece I wanna pop up. All right, I've got this fun little edge going all the way around. I can go ahead and adhere this little panel. You could do it tilted or straight. I chose to do it straight. I've got these Hello Word bubble shapes and you've got a whole pack. So you're gonna have lots and lots to play with. Smile we're going to use on this card, and hello we'll use in a minute, so I went ahead and pulled those out already. And then for this little guy, I want to grab a little scrap of our watermelon. Remember, we trimmed our watermelon earlier. So in order to make this show up a little bit better, it shows up pretty good on the black, but for a pop of color and to make it stand out a little more, I'm going to go ahead and glue this little guy. So in your circle around die, this is really a fun die set because, like I said, it has circles all the way down to this tiniest little circle right in the middle. That's the circle I used to also cut some polka dots. So we're gonna dress up this black panel a little bit. And then this last dot, I want to kind of hang over the bottom edge a little bit. So I'm just gonna trim a little bit away and kind of make it look like it's kind of dropping off the edge there. So bring back your sticker pack. I'm gonna use the largest party fan here. And then I thought it would be fun to add this little kind of pick on the top. But because this blue is such the perfect color, I'm going to bring back a little bit of our twine and just tie it around the bottom of the stick in a fun little bow. Makes it a little more festive, I think. I want it about here, so I'm going to add a little bit of glue underneath just to make sure that pick stays in right. Before I put this down firmly, so cute. And all it's needing is our little sentiment here. It's stuck on there pretty good. Now all I'm going to do is just simply go around the edge of this word bubble. Luckily it's not too complicated. And just trim that extra pink away. All right, grab a couple little foam squares, pop them behind here. Just fun, simple, festive. Again, change the color combination, change the pattern paper, and you've got a completely different look for your card. Love that one. All right, so I'm gonna quickly bring our birthday balloons back that have their strings hanging all over still. I feel like they're probably dry enough. I don't want to pull them out, but all you want to do is gather up all of your strings and don't try to do it too tight. Kind of leave them a little bit loose. You want them to have that nice flowy look. And then I just brought them together and tied a little, just a single knot. And again, you don't have to have it super tight. And then in order to have this not just, you know, flapping off your card, add a little dot of glue here. And you can position it however you want. So fun. So now you've got your fun balloons, you've got your, you know, all your little tails tied, and again, kind of adjust them, get them just how you want, and super cute. It was awesome, you guys. We've got 1, 2, 3 cards done. 2 more to go. Okay, our next card is super fun. This is using those great snapshot frames, and I wonder if you were surprised. When I first saw these, I was surprised that they're not plastic frames or anything. They're actually wood frames, so they're really fun. They're really sturdy. They've really got a lot of beef to them. They're not chipboards. I thought they were really fun. So we're going to be using that on this next card, and we're going to be using our Summer Days card base. Make it bright and shiny here. So again, same size as the others, 5.5 inches. Do you guys see how I sometimes turn my card back inside on itself? Seems like it just gives my crease a little extra fold to it. Okay, we'll bring our pattern paper back, but I'm gonna grab 2 out for this project. So we want this the same as that striped one, 4 by 5.25. I just can never get enough of polka dots. I don't know about you guys, but. Okay, now in order to kind of get our words for behind our frame, you can do it 2 different ways. You can trim it to fit the frame, or you could actually glue it first and then trim the paper away. So 3.25 by 3.5. Now I'll just go ahead and put a little bit of glue on the back of my frame. I don't want to get it too low down here. I'm going to be adding some foam dots to that, but I love how it pops against that black frame. All right, so we're going to bring your Border Basics die set back in again. And this time I use a little strip of our watermelon, and I actually cut the same exact border. I think I meant to cut this little one with a stitching edge, but I didn't. You certainly could. Now, I love the arrows on this card, but I thought, you know what? Maybe we want it a little bit more girly. So if you are making this for a girl, I suggest adding the little border. It's just going to cover up those arrows, but it's just a fun way to make the frame look a little bit different. Now, even if the die cut goes a little higher, I'm totally fine with that. I want to make sure that I have a little bit of black in the bottom. On my original card, I had Make Today Awesome in teal, but I'm going to go ahead and cut one out of pink because I think I cut all my teal ones up. So I think I will use, remember I had the scrap of teal? I think I'll go ahead and cut a skinny little strip. You just kind of need something to put behind this word because it is, you know, pattern paper, so it's a little thinner. I'm going to leave a little bit extra room on the side so I can, so I can cut a little kind of banner cut on the edge and have room to tuck this in. I'm going to take some more of our twine. I think I'll wrap it maybe three times. And I'm going to kind of tie the bow over on the right side because I want my sentiment over here. Tie a knot, make sure that stays nice and snug, and then just tie yourself a nice little bow. You could even do something fancy like a double bow or something if you wanted to. So again, I said we're going to be using lots of these stickers from our sticker sheet here. This time I'm going to grab the smaller little fan, and then I grab this little blue flower too. So Make Today Awesome, I'm going to trim pretty close here because I'm going to kind of tuck it in. And then like I said, this side I'm going to do a cute little banner cut. Okay, bring in a couple foam squares. And then this little guy can kind of tuck it in wherever you want. Kind of like it at a little bit of an angle. I don't want to cover up all of our cute little scallops, right? Now we're ready to actually put the frame on the card. And you can glue it down or you can pop it back up again. So it's just popped up and like I said, quick, easy, fun. Looks like you spent a lot of time making this card, but really by the time it all came together, it was certainly not difficult. Just kind of plug and play and off you go. Super cute. All right, our last card. I can't believe it. Now what we want to do is grab... I'm going to actually grab my last full sheet of white cardstock that I have. And I'm going to cut a couple panels out of our extra piece. So once we cut our card base, then like I said, I'll show you what we'll do with our extra paper. So card base, I'm going to set that aside. Once we've got our trimmer out, I'm going to go ahead and flip it around. I'm going to cut this in half again. So that would be at 4 1/4. And I'm going to leave it the whole 5 1/2 tall. So that's just basically your card front. Set that aside. And then I'm going to use this extra card front, which of course is the same size as the original. And I'm going to cut it at 2 1/2 inches. So one piece at 2 1/2. I know, I'm sorry, it's white on white. It's hard to tell, isn't it? And then I just want to cut one little 3/4 inch strip. And you will see why we're cutting these odd strips in just a minute. All right. Now I'm going to pop up this white one on top, and it seems a little silly to pop up white on white, but you're going to see why. But before I actually pop anything up, let's talk about decorating the inside of this panel. So the reason we cut these two guys is because now we're going to create a fun little shadow effect on the front of our card. So you can kind of see where I have the 2 1/2 inch strip and the 3/4 inch strip. And then inside this strip, we're going to create a fun little background. So in order to do that, I need you to bring in all three colors, or actually all four colors from your kit. You should have plenty of scraps left over and your black too. Doesn't really matter how big or long they are. If you have smaller scraps, that's totally fine. But you're just going to want to come in and cut at least several half inch strips from all four of these colors. So I'm going to quickly do that. Okay, so I've got all my fun little strips here, and trust me, it's going to be more than you need, but that's okay. And then I'm just going to take these strips. I'm actually going to trim them a little bit smaller, and they don't have to be even, but I'm going to trim them maybe about 2 inches long or so, just to kind of stack them up here. Okay, so I have all my fun little strips, and now I can just come along, and again, using your wet glue or your tape runner or whatever you want to do. Just take your strips and put them in kind of a pattern. You could do random if you want, but I did a pattern where I repeated. And just continue all the way down until you've got this entire strip on your extra panel. Remember, this is not your card base, this is your card panel. So just continue on until all your color is all filled in. Like I said, you'll probably have some strips left over. You could probably do multiples of this card. If you do have any cardstock hanging over, like I have this little orange and pink here, just go ahead and trim that away. You can even go in a little bit since you probably haven't glued right to the edge. So it might look a little crazy now, but watch the magic happen when we add our other strips to the sides. Our 2 1/2 inch strip is going to go on the left. You may want to put a couple extra foam squares on that edge that touches the patterned paper or the solid paper. And then it's magically going to make my seam look very straight. And I'll do the same with the other side. So you've got this really fun card front now that's got this, you know, kind of inlaid piece right here. So now we've got grabbing a little piece of our summer days here. Same technique as we did before. So I'll quickly glue this on and then show you how we're going to layer up the rest of the elements. We're going to bring back our stickers in, which we don't have a whole lot left. Remember the watermelon we took off? The pomegranate is actually the only sticker I did not use out of this whole pack, so that's pretty funny. I'm going to trim this sentiment apart. Even though this is the last card that I'm completing, I think it ended up being my favorite card. It's just simple and sweet, and I love the technique that you could repeat with different colors and do so many times, and it would be so cute. All right, so very simple. A little watermelon here. I'll do our hello next. I'm just going to adhere that. So it's just kind of fun, tropical. I love the colors of this one. So that's all there is to our very last card. So maybe I'll bring all of them back in because you guys did an amazing job. I love, love, love every single one of them. My balloons and my little tag card. Is this not fun? This is such a fun, colorful group of cards. I just love it. All right, you guys did great. I want to thank you again for creating with me with our Birthday Basics Die Bundle. I hope you love it as much as I do. And if you're watching the video and haven't purchased the bundle, definitely go to our site at spellbinderspaperarts.com and you can find the bundle there. Pick it up, it's a great deal. And I know that you will, as always, enjoy bringing paper to life.